All right, kids, once again, do not try this at home. Hey guys, what's going on? This is Tyler from Nelly Security, and in today's video, we are going to fix this Uniview RJ45 connection. Now, in our last two videos in this series, we showed you how to fix an R-series connection and an H-series connection. And both of those cameras were slightly complicated to fix just because of those unusual pinout diagrams. But if you need to fix your RJ45 connection on a Uniview security camera, I do have good news for you. This is actually going to be quite a bit simpler than our H-series and R-series cameras because the pinout diagram for Uniview cameras is identical to the T568-B Ethernet standard. In the past two videos, I showed you how to fix your Ethernet connection using an Ethernet coupler. I am going to show you a different process in this video. So let's go ahead and jump right in, and I will show you exactly what tools you need for this process. Alright, first we will need our camera with the damaged Ethernet cable. Next, we are going to need a Keystone jack, which is essentially the RJ45 female connection. There are two kinds of Keystone jacks you can choose from, the kind that requires a punchdown tool, and the kind that requires no extra tool. That said, you may also need a punchdown tool for this. You'll also need some way to strip the outer jacket of your Ethernet cable, either some wire cutters. I'm just gonna use this simple Cat5 cable stripper. We sell all of these tools at nellysecurity.com, and I will link those down in the description below. Now let's get into the process. All right, our first step here is just to cut off this damaged connector. Then we are going to strip back this Ethernet cable and reveal the twisted pairs inside. Go ahead and untwist those wires so we have 8 individual strands. Again, the pinout diagram for Uniview cameras is identical to the standard T658-B, so the order of these wires is going to be orange stripe orange, green stripe blue, blue stripe green, and brown stripe brown. All right, now let's get these wires laid out in our Keystone jack. First, I'm going to show you how to do this on the standard traditional Keystone jack that requires a punchdown tool. So first, you'll take your Ethernet cable and lay it there in the center of the jack. And we are going to lay each of these 8 wires in one of these terminals. You can see on the sides there, we do have some color coding. And again, we're going to be following the B standard. If you're using one of these Keystone jacks with an H-series or an R-series camera, be sure to follow the number instead of the color. To see which color corresponds to the number, go ahead and check out our blog post in the description below. There you'll find diagrams for H-series and R-series, so you can figure out which color goes where. But for Uniview, it's fine to use that color coding diagram because it's going to be the same. Now, when you're using your punchdown tool, you will want to hold this so the blade is out. That blade is going to cut off our excess wire. Once we have everything in place, just punch down and it puts that wire right there in between those conductors. So on the left side from top to bottom, we have orange, orange stripe, green, and green stripe, or if you don't have Uniview, 2, 1, 6, 3. On the right side, we are going to follow the order brown, brown stripe, blue, blue stripe, or for a non-Uniview camera, we will follow the numbers 8, 7, 4, 5. Pull off all the excess wires still hanging on and add your dust covers. And congratulations, you have successfully fixed your RJ45 connector. If you don't have a punchdown tool handy, you can pick up one of these toolless jacks, which allows you to fasten the wires into place without any additional tools. These can be a little bit more convenient, especially if you're in a pinch and you don't have another tool handy. However, I do prefer the control that the punchdown tool offers. It lets me place those cables in one by one, whereas with this connector, you do have to line all those wires up at the same time, and it can be more of a hassle. To do this, you will take your stripped Ethernet cable and push it into the hole right there at the top. And once again, we are just going to line this up with the number, and if you have a Uniview camera, the color. Since we're technically doing this upside down, it is going to be a slightly different order. And again, be sure to follow the B standard there. So from top to bottom on the left, brown, brown stripe, blue, blue stripe. And on the right side, from top to bottom, we're going to go orange, orange stripe, and green, green stripe. If you have an H-series or an R-series camera, just focus on those numbers instead of the colors. And we are going to go 8, 7, 4, 5, and on the right side, 2163. Once you have all those wires in the correct position, make sure everything is nice and clean in the center there. We are going to close this connector until we hear a clicking sound. Now, to get off all these excess wires, since we don't have a punch down tool, we're going to use this little lever that came with the connector. We're going to stick it there at the bottom. It clicks right into place. And we are going to push down to use the blades built into this connector to cut off those excess wires. You may have to twist these a little bit to get them to come off all the way. And with that, we now have a successfully punched down connector, and we can now use this as our RJ45 connection. Now let's go ahead and test this out. As we plug this in, we do have IR lights coming on, which means this camera is receiving power. And let's jump onto Easy Tools to see if we're getting any data connection. And as you can see here, it looks like we are. We have power, we have data. This camera is once again fully functional. Once again, be sure to check out those links in the description below to find out where you can purchase all of these products on our website. You can also check out our blog post, which is linked down there. That blog post will walk you through everything step by step for H-Series, R-Series, Uniview. Whether you decide to use Ethernet couplers or Keystone jacks, you will find all the diagrams you need over there. Well, that about wraps it up for this series, looking at the RJ45 connections on our cameras, examining these pinout diagrams, and learning how to fix your camera's Ethernet connection. I hope you learned something. I hope this was helpful for you. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us across social media so you never miss another video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.